The land of the free and the home of the brave may take on a different meaning for the tens of thousands of Bhutanese refugees who have resettled in the U.S., including the Rochester area. One of the fastest growing refugee populations in America is dealing with a suicide issue. According to a study by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, the issue is endemic. Why is this happening? What role, if any, does the so-called American dream play? And what creative approaches are being implemented to address a difficult topic in the Bhutanese culture, mental health? Joining me to discuss this issue is Prajeet Magar, Executive Director of the Bhutanese Community of Greater Rochester, Jim Sutton, Director of Community Medicine at Rochester Regional Health System, and Karan, Thapa, a Bhutanese peer counselor at Rochester Regional Health System and the President of the Bhutanese Community of Greater Rochester. I appreciate all of you being here. Thank you.
Thanks.
So, Bhutanese refugees in Rochester have dealt with, and from my understanding, are still reeling from one local suicide. And since 2008, when the U.S. began resettling Bhutanese refugees from camps in Nepal, there have been approximately 55 suicides on U.S. soil. I've read some believe the number is higher than that. And Prajeet and Karan, the question I'm sure many viewers want to know is, and I'm sure the answers are deep and there are many layers to the answer, is why is this happening? And how does this happen after the transition from life in a refugee camp to life here in America?
Okay. The first thing is depression, as everybody knows that depression is the primary cause for suicide. But in our case, I would say isolation. People come here with dream, and once they're totally isolated and they can't really be as free as they used to be. That is one of the reasons. Hopelessness is another one. They come here with hope, dream, and they come here with a dream that it's a new luck for them. It's a good luck. It's a fortune to be here. But once they start feeling that, once they start to get some such huge, big challenges, then those dreams, those hopes, those luck, they will curse on that. So when people start cursing their luck, that's the point where people give up. And that's one of the reasons. And there are other reasons, could be like, I don't want to say drug, but probably alcohol abuse could be a reason. In our society, pride and self-guilt is another reason. Because pride plays a big role in the community, in our society. So. For example, you gamble. You're used to with gambling. For example, let's say, just an example. You have drug and alcohol abuse problem. That has to do a lot with demolishing the pride of your family, and that leads to suicide. One of the reasons only. So the other than that, yeah, hopelessness, solitude, and depression.
So it sounds like that pursuit of the American dream is also it's a double-edged sword, in essence. And I want to ask you this, Jim, and I want to tie this in terms of addressing some of these issues that Prajeet brought up and the depression. How difficult, or what makes it difficult for doctors here in the U.S. to diagnose some of those very issues that he addressed, the emotional and mental health issues of a Bhutanese patient?
It's very difficult. If you think about it, a broken leg or a heart attack, the treatment of that's very scientifically based and can be transferred across humans, in any country. But behavioral issues, mental health issues are very culturally based. And the language and the way we approach mental health in the U.S. is much different than in other cultures. And so it's not uncommon for a U.S. traditional patient to come in and say, I feel a little depressed. You know, I think I need to go see a therapist. You're not going to get that from a patient from Bhutan. They think about it differently. They talk about it differently. And it can be very difficult to have that conversation with them and really start to get to the root cause of what's going on with them.
I'm going to give just some numbers from a CDC study. The suicide rate among Bhutanese living in the United States is 20.3 per 100,000 people, and that's nearly double the rate for U.S. residents. It's also higher than the global suicide rate at 16 per 100,000 people. Karan, we hear the numbers. How is the local Bhutanese community responding? What are the reactions? Is there a sense of fear that the trend could continue? Are discussions taking place within the community?
Yes.
There is a fear among the people, not only in Rochester, but all across the U.S., that this trend may continue, because seeing the number given by the CDC, that it's double the rate in comparison to what it is in the U.S. Yes, the trend may continue. I also feel like that, because as Prajeet already pointed out, some of the reasons behind people committing suicide here in the U.S. And yes, community in Rochester has come up, they've stepped up and started taking some actions, in the sense we all started in the closed room meeting in my apartment when I had called a couple of friends first to come and discuss about what's going on with regard to committing suicide, because we already had one case here in Rochester. And we had only a moderate number of participants at that time. And I also didn't have that courage to invite everyone, because suicide in our community back in Nepal, or especially in Bhutan also, there's a social stigma attached to it. But in my experience, when I called a couple of friends at that time for a meeting, I found them to be very receptive. And like, so they are breaking out of the bond of stigma today, and people are ready to talk about it, because they have felt the need to step up and do something in order to stop this from happening. And yes, Bhutanese community across US, they have also started doing some mental health counseling program also, which I attended one recently this year in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. So people are all ready to curb action against committing suicide. And also, yes, people are today very aware that there is some help. So people can go and share their feelings and approach to someone so that they can seek help. Because it only needs a single reason for people to commit suicide. And some of the reasons have already been quoted by Prajeet.
I want to talk about one effort that's underway to help, and it's very creative. It's a Bollywood-style film that was done here in Rochester, and to really raise awareness and to bring about dialogues, and you mentioned this, to step out of that box and to approach this in a creative way. And so I want to understand, why Bollywood style? Tell me about the decision to kind of go after that genre as opposed to a more serious genre to bring about these discussions.
Yes. I came up with the idea of having to come together and create awareness among the people. And the Bollywood style movie that's been done to create awareness among the people is done by one of our friends who has been an artist in Nepali Bollywood industry. But why Bollywood style? It could be because everybody or whoever is known to the world of movies is known to or attest somehow to Bollywood style, because Bollywood movies are very popular in our area. They are in Bhutan, in Nepal. So of course we share India, we share common border with India. So that's where from Bollywood movie comes from. Yes. So everybody watches YouTube movies. So it's mostly Bollywood movie style. So to make it catchy, yep, and more understandable, and make it like easier for people to access to it and also understand, have the better grasp of the idea.
Jim, I want to ask you, what role does the local health community play in all of this? Why there are mental health care treatment there that is available to refugee populations here. Is mental health literacy needed? Is there something more that can be done to break down the barriers to these conversations in addition to approaches such as this?
Much more needs to be done, and efforts like this are just wonderful. And what we did a few years ago is we started hiring some people called peer counselors, which are previously resettled refugees that meet new refugees coming into Rochester and develop a relationship with them and start working on some of the assimilation issues. And we've discovered that to get to the root of this problem, it's not the traditional, I think you need to see a therapist and be on some medicines. It's more getting into the community and having them have an understanding of what's going on and having them kind of lift themselves up and normalize the situation themselves. And so what we're trying to do as a healthcare community is support and promote these type of activities, because we know it's going to have a big effect down the road.
Prajeet, we've got about 30 seconds left, not enough time, but just to close, we have viewers that care and they watch this, and on the community level, they'll say, what can we do to help, even in the transition of refugees who come here, to help beyond 3 months, to make it a better transition for them? What would you say?
Give them a sense of belonging.
A sense of belonging.
Yes, hope. Giving job is not enough. How are you treated in your job? What role have you been playing? Do you know the signs and symptoms of suicide? Can you be responsible? Would you take responsibility before it's too late? These are the things that community could help us with.
Karan, Thapa, Jim Sutton, and Prajeet Magar, thank you all for your time today. For more information on what you just heard or how you can get involved with suicide prevention efforts for the Bhutanese community of Greater Rochester, connect with the group through Facebook. Members can be reached at facebook.com/bcgrnyorg.